Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, early in the morning hours from now through the end of this year, you will be able to see not only Venus very high in the southeastern sky, but also Jupiter rising towards Venus, which it has gone past Mercury. And you can use those two brighter planets to help you locate Mercury for the rest of this week. So check this out on Christmas morning, if you happen to get up early prior to your kids, even if you are up wrapping presents, you can still see Mercury just by drawing a line from Venus right down, and you'll be able to find Mercury about 4 degrees away from the bright planet Jupiter. I found it on Christmas Eve morning fairly easily. Wasn't too difficult to see, and I tend to think that Mercury is not difficult to find as long as it's still about 5 degrees above the horizon, which it will be for the rest of this year. So, as we go ahead in time, you can see how Jupiter pulls away from Mercury, but Mercury is still kind of hanging around there. On the 27th, it's still up a ways, although the sky's getting a little bit brighter at the same exact time. And then on the 29th and 30th, it's quite a bit further, Jupiter's quite a bit further away. Now for Mercury, you're looking at a good almost 9 degrees difference. And then by the 30th, you're probably looking at about that distance. And by the 31st, a little bit more. But check out this cool thing that happens on the 31st. You have the Moon, and then Venus, and then Jupiter, and then Mercury that all form this incredible line, almost perfectly straight in the sky. Very large line, as you can see. That's going to be a good, let's see how far that's going to be, 45 degrees. So that's a long distance. It's easily a one quarter of the sky, as the sky is about 180 degrees across from horizon to horizon. But if you have a fairly wide field lens, you might be able to get a photo of all of these if you get up early enough. And you only need to be up probably an hour, maybe a little bit more than that before sunrise. Just make sure that you're looking about 45 minutes before to capture Mercury, because that's going to kind of be your ideal time between it being too bright for the sun, washing it out, and Mercury being high enough up that you can actually see it too. That tends to be about the right time that I find is good, is about 45 minutes before the sun actually rises. So look for your local sunrise time. That's going to be a little different if you're very far north, because your angle of your horizon is going to be a little bit different, and when things actually rise will be a little bit different. But for the 30 to 50 degrees or so north latitude, you should be okay with all of that. So check those out in the coming week or so before the end of 2018 in the morning skies. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.